I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Insight into Chemical Engineering. In this lecture series, we will solve the unsolved problem of a famous book, Stoichiometry and Process Calculations by Kevin Arend. These lectures are helpful for chemical engineering students because process calculation is a core subject for chemical engineering branch. During lecture, step-by-step solution will be provided. In this lecture, exercise number 4.1 to 4.8 will be covered. Please like and subscribe for motivation. Problem number 4.1, how many kilograms of nitrogen will occupy a volume of 1000 meter cube at a pressure of 1.2 bar and a temperature of 400 Kelvin? So in this problem, using ideal gas law, we can estimate the number of moles of nitrogen, and from number of moles, we can estimate the weight of nitrogen. So first we will find out the number of moles. So we can write PV is equal to nRT. So number of moles will become equal to PV by RT. Now we can write the values of pressure, volume, gas constant and temperature. So we need to take the value of gas constant according to the units of pressure, volume and temperature. So here pressure is given in Pascal and volume is given in meter cube. So accordingly we will take R equal to 8.314. So number of moles will come out as 36.08 kilomole. Now we can estimate the weight of nitrogen. So weight of nitrogen will be equal to moles of nitrogen into its molecular weight, and it will come out as 1010.24 kg. Problem number 4.2. A gas occupies a volume of 100 meter cube at given temperature and pressure. So what volume will gas occupy at different temperature and pressure? So again we can use the ideal gas equation. This time two states of gas are given. So at both states we can use the ideal gas equation. So at state 1 we can write P1V1 equal to nRT1, and corresponding to this state we can write the values of pressure, volume and temperature. So pressure is given, that is 1.25 into 10 raised to power 5 Pascal, and volume is given 100 meter cube, and n is number of moles into gas constant into temperature. Now we can use P2V2 equal to nRT2 at second state. So at second state we can write the values of pressure, volume and temperature. Now we can simply divide both equations and we can estimate the value of V2. So n is same in both cases because the number of moles of gas are not changing, only the volume will change by changing the temperature pressure conditions. So by dividing both equation we can estimate the volume. So volume at second state will come out as 91.67 meter cube. Now problem number 4.3. 20 kg of chlorine is to be stored in a container at 0.9 bar and 295 Kelvin. What should be the volume of the container? So in this case, weight of chlorine is given. So first we can find out the moles of chlorine, then we can use the ideal gas equation to estimate the volume. So moles of chlorine will be equal to weight of chlorine divided by its molecular weight, and it will come out as 281.69 mole. Now volume can be estimated using ideal gas equation and it will come out as 7.68 meter cube. Problem number 4.4. How many kilograms of liquid water will be obtained by the complete condensation of 5 meter cube water vapor at 200 kilopascal and 1000 Kelvin? So in part A, we need to find out the weight of liquid in kilogram. So initially we have water vapors at certain temperature, pressure and volume conditions, and we are condensing these water vapors into liquid. So we need to find out the weight of liquid. So if we can estimate the weight of water vapor, then the weight of liquid will be same. So first we need to find out the moles of water vapors, then we can convert these water vapors to kilogram. So using ideal gas equation, we can find out the number of moles of water vapor, because pressure, volume and temperature conditions are given, and we are assuming these water vapors are behaving ideal gas behavior. So number of moles will come out as 120.28 mole. So weight of water will be equal to moles of water vapor into its molecular weight. So it will come out as 2.165 kg. Now part B. In part B, the steam table gives the specific volume of water vapor to be 2.937 meter cube per kg. So using this data, calculate the mass of water vapor obtained and compare with the result in part A. So we can write the specific volume equal to volume per unit mass. So we can see it from the unit. So unit of water vapor is given in meter cube per kg. So that is the specific volume of water vapor. So if it was given in meter cube per mole, then we would have written volume per unit moles. So here it is given in volume per unit mass. So we will write specific volume equal to volume per unit mass. Now we can find out the mass. So mass will be equal to volume divided by specific volume. So in part A, volume is given, that is 5 meter cube, and specific volume is given. So we can estimate the mass. So these meter cube will cancel and unit will come out as in kg. So mass will come out as 1.702 kg. Now if we will compare the mass obtained in part A and in part B, they are totally different. So this is the experimental value and this is the estimated from ideal gas law. So what we can say, that the water vapors at the given condition, that is 200 kilopascal and 1000 Kelvin, they are not obeying the ideal gas law. That's why we are getting more weight of water when we are using the ideal gas equation. So basically, weight of water is more when we are estimating it using ideal gas equation. It means at the given conditions, water vapor are not obeying the ideal gas law. Problem number 4.5. Steam tables gives the specific volume of superheated steam at given temperature and pressure. So specific volume is given in term of meter cube per kg. How does it compare with the value obtained by the ideal gas equation? So we will use ideal gas equation to estimate this specific volume in term of meter cube per kg. Then we can compare it with the given value. So using ideal gas equation, we can write PV is equal to nRT. N is number of moles. So further, number of moles can be written as weight divided by molecular weight. So we can write N equal to weight divided by molecular weight. Now we can rearrange equation in such a way so that we can obtain the specific volume. So simply we need to divide this volume by weight. So specific volume will become equal to RT divided by 18 into pressure. So this 18 is the molecular weight of water. Now by putting all values, we can estimate the specific volume. So the unit of specific volume is in term of meter cube per gram. So we need to convert this gram to kg. So after converting this to meter cube per kg, we can compare it with the experimental value and we can find out the percentage increment. So percentage increment is 0.75. Now problem number 4.6. It is desired to compress 7 kg of nitrogen gas to a volume of 0.5 meter cube at 305 Kelvin. Calculate the pressure required. So we can use the ideal gas equation. 7 kg of nitrogen gas is given. First find out the number of moles of nitrogen gas. Then using ideal gas equation, we can estimate the pressure. So moles of nitrogen will be equal to weight of nitrogen divided by its molecular weight. And it will come out as 250 mole. Now using ideal gas equation, we can write pressure equal to nRT by V. Now by putting all values, we can estimate the pressure. So pressure will come out as 12.67 bar. Now problem number 4.7. A fire extinguisher tank can hold 1 meter cube of gas. The tank contains 10 kg of CO2 at 300 Kelvin. What will be the pressure of gas in Newton per meter square? So Newton per meter square means Pascal. So again we will use the ideal gas equation. So using ideal gas equation, we can estimate the pressure of the gas. So initially we have given 10 kg of CO2. So first find out the number of moles of CO2. So number of moles of CO2 will be equal to weight of CO2 divided by its molecular weight. Now we can use the ideal gas equation. So pressure will be equal to nRT by volume. Now by putting the values of temperature, volume, number of moles and gas constant, we can estimate the pressure and it will come out as in term of Pascal. Now problem number 4.8. A 20 liter glass vessel contains 28 gram nitrogen. If the vessel cannot withstand a pressure exceeding 120 kPa, up to what temperature the gas in the vessel can be heated? So this is the final condition. So as per final conditions, we can estimate the temperature because this is the pressure that can be withstand by vessel. So corresponding to this maximum pressure, we can find out the temperature. So again we will use the ideal gas equation. So we will find out the number of moles of nitrogen. So first we can write 20 liter to meter cube. Now moles of nitrogen will be equal to weight of nitrogen divided by its molecular weight, and moles of nitrogen will come out as 1 mole. Now using ideal gas equation, we can estimate the maximum temperature corresponding to maximum pressure. So by putting the all values, we will get temperature equal to 288.67 Kelvin.